Welcome and thank you for joining me. I'm Jerry Ojinski, a New York medical malpractice and personal injury trial lawyer practicing law here in the state of New York. Today's video tip is a little bit different, and it asks the question, should an attorney in New York who learns that they have been communicating by Twitter, which is a social networking site, with a juror on their case, does that attorney have an obligation to inform his adversary about that, as well as the court, during the course of the litigation? The answer is yes. Here's why. Attorneys are prevented from communicating with jurors at any time during the course of trial. During jury selection, attorneys are told, and they tell jurors, potential jurors, that we cannot communicate with you outside of the courtroom. Any communication, any questions you have before we start the trial has to be in the presence of both attorneys. During the course of trial, we communicate to jurors through the use of witnesses and through documentary evidence. And at the beginning of the case, we present an overview of what we believe the proof will show. And at the end of the case, we are allowed to summarize the evidence of what we believe the proof has shown in this case. In today's prevalence of people using social networking sites like Facebook and Twitter and MySpace, it's conceivable that an attorney can be communicating with somebody, let's say on Twitter, and not realize that that person may be involved in their own case. However, if the attorney learns that a juror has been using Twitter to communicate anonymously with the attorney, and for some reason, some communication, the attorney learns that that person is a juror, the lawyer has an absolute obligation to tell the judge and to tell the adversary about that communication. If they don't, it could be an ethical breach, and if one of the parties learns later on that the attorney was communicating, it could be grounds for a mistrial or overturning the verdict. And that's it for today's video tip about social networking sites and what an attorney's obligation is if they now learn that they've been communicating with someone who is sitting on their jury. I'm Jerry Ojinski. Thank you for joining me. Have a great day.